collection and arrangement of data. Hey kids! In this video, we will learn about the collection and arrangement of data. Come, let's take you to the jungle, where the wise owl is waiting for some animals. Every day, they learn some new things from the wise owl. Oh, here you come. How did you all get so late today?
Chiku was playing, Bhalu was trying to steal honey, and Saloni was sleeping.
And Chichi was studying.
Okay, let's learn something new today. Do you want to play a game?
Yes.
So kids, here is a dice.
Now all of you will roll the dice 5 times. We will write down the numbers you get on rolling the die.
Okay.
I will roll first. 1, 4, 6, 2, 2.
So, Chiku got these numbers on the dice. Now, Bhalu, it's your turn.
Okay. 2, 4, 5, 5, 4.
So, Bhalu got these numbers on the dice. Now, Chichi and Saloni, turn-wise roll the dice and see what numbers you get.
1, 1, 3, 4, 6. 5, 4, 5, 6, 6.
So, Chichi and Saloni got these numbers on the dice. Now we have made a list of the numbers that you all got by rolling the dice. So children, I can say, in this way I have collected all the points you got by rolling the dice. This kind of information is also known as data. So I can also say, I have collected the information about the points you got by rolling the dice.
Okay.
Can you give one more example of data?
Yes, of course. See, if I want to know how many members are there in your family, I can make a list by asking you all the number of members present in each one of your family. For example, look at this list. By looking at this list, we can easily find out whose family has the most members and whose family has the least. But if we closely look at this data, can you tell which number hit the dice most of the times? What happened? Why are you taking so much time?
Because we have to first check how many times each number has hit the die.
Perfect. And for this, we can arrange and write our data in this way. Like, we got 1 for 3 times, we also got 2 for 3 times. And like this, we can write 4 different numbers.
Oh wow! You have made a different set for all the numbers.
Perfect! First of all, we made a collection of all the numbers. And did you notice how I have arranged all the numbers from 1 to 6 in a way that makes easy to gather the information? Now tell me, which number came for the highest times and which one for the least?
4 came for the highest times, that is 5 times, and 3 came for the least, only once.
Absolutely right. So kids, in this video, we have learnt about the collection and arrangement of data. Collection and arrangement of data. Hey kids, in this video we will learn about the collection and arrangement of data with the help of examples.
Sister, sister.
Oh, what happened today? You all came together?
There is a fair in the neighboring village. Will you take us there?
Definitely, if you promise me one thing.
What promise, sister?
That you all will hold each other's hand so that nobody gets lost.
Yes, sister. We will not leave each other's hand.
Okay, so let's get ready to go to the fair. But before going there, I'll ask some questions. Answer me by raising your hands.
Okay, sister.
So first of all, let's find out the choice of your swings and games, so that it makes easy for us to buy tickets tomorrow. So tell me, who wants to take a ride on the giant wheel? 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, and 6.
Sister, I get scared.
It's okay, you can enjoy other rides. Now tell me, who wants to take ride on roundabout? 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9, and 10. Wow!
I feel dizziness on it.
It's okay, you can enjoy some other games. Now tell me, who wants to play Pop the Balloon? 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9, 10, and 11. Oh wow, everyone would like to play this game.
Yes, sister, one gets prize on winning this game.
Now tell me, who wants to play and win with Throw the Rings? 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, and 8.
Sis, what have you made?
I have prepared a list of table according to your wishes. This will help me to know how many tickets I have to buy for each game. Can you tell how many total tickets we have to buy?
35.
Can you tell which game needs the most number of tickets?
Pop the Balloon.
Right, now tell me, for how many games I have to buy more than 8 tickets?
2.
Absolutely correct. So, did you see, when I collected the data and arranged it into a tabular form, how easily you have given answers to my questions?
Yes, sister. Sister, let's discuss one more example based on data collection and arrangement.
Yes, right. We'll also get late while playing there. So, let's collect some data related to foods. So now tell me, who all wants to enjoy Golgappe? 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, and 7. Who all wants to eat cotton candy? 1, 2, 3, 4, and 5.
Sister, I have cavities, so I can't eat sweet things.
Okay, who all wants to eat samosas? 1, 2, and 3. Who all wants to eat bread pakoras? 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, and 7. Who all wants to eat ice cream?
1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, and 8.
Sister, what have you made?
Look, this is known as pictograph. In this, with the help of pictures, I have shown the number of kids with the choices of food. By closely looking at this pictograph, tell me which food is highly chosen by the kids.
Ice cream.
Absolutely right. Now tell me, what should we buy more? Samosas or bread pakoras?
Bread pakora.
Right. Now tell me, how many kids love golgappas?
7.
Very good. So kids, pictograph is also a very good way to represent data in an organized manner. Have you seen how easily and fastly we have answered with the help of these?
Yes, sister.
Now all of you should go home. We'll meet tomorrow at 11 to go to the fair. So kids, today we have learnt about collecting and arranging data in a tabular form or a pictograph.
Kids, in this video, we have learnt about the collection and arrangement of data with the help of examples. Common misconceptions related to collection and arrangement of data. Hey kids, in the previous video, you have learnt about the collection and arrangement of data in tabular and pictographic form. In this video, we will learn about some common misconceptions related to collection and arrangement of data. We often make mistakes in the collection of data. For example, look at these numbers and tell how many numbers are greater than 2 and the number of times they have appeared. We usually get confused, should we count in 2 or not? Let's look at this example. Some kitchen items and their numbers are shown here in a tabular form. Which items are more than 6 in numbers?
Spoon and glass.
Is it the right answer?
I think just the glass, because you asked more than 6. Therefore, we cannot consider 6.
Absolutely right. While counting more than a particular number, the number itself is not considered. But Saloni, if I would have asked which kitchen item is more than or equal to 6, then your answer would be correct.
Oh, now I get it.
So now can you tell me, which kitchen item is less than 6 in number?
Knife and bowl.
Absolutely right. While counting less than a particular number, the number itself is not considered. Similarly, if we look at the numbers of items which are either 6 or less than 6 in the tabular form, we will get knife, bowl, and spoons. So now your confusion must have been cleared. While counting more or less than a particular number, the number itself is not considered. Sometimes it has also been seen that while looking for answers from the pictograph, children do not pay attention to the key given on it. In this pictograph, we are showing a relation between the children's books and the number of kids who like them. By looking at the pictograph, can you tell me how many kids love fairy tales?
5.
Let me say 10.
Chi-Chi has rightly answered this question. Often, we only count the number of pictures, but forget to notice the list given with it. Here, each stick man depicts 2 children. So, 5 pictures will depict 10 children. So, by making such lists, we can easily show data with less pictures in the pictograph. Now again, take a look at the pictograph.
Who will tell me how many kids love horror books?
But here we have only half a stick man.
Right. If a whole stick man means 2 children, then half the stick man will mean
1 child.
Right. So, how many children love horror books?
3.
Absolutely right. So, kids, in this video, we have learnt about some common misconceptions related to collection and arrangement of data.